Happy morning. Good morning to everybody. Happy morning to everybody. So today, we are going to celebrate and we are going to do a few asanas, which is in the form of different poses. Happy morning, sir. Vanakkam, vanakkam. Happy morning to everybody. Okay, great. So today is the day, just like another day that has been celebrated. Today is the World International Yoga Day. I would say this is the 6th International Yoga Day. But according to me, it should be 2000 plus or 5000 plus. We don't know what is the number of years that has to be celebrated. And it is nice to be a part of the celebration. And yogam abdin solumbode, it is very simple, very authentic form of understanding. We have a greatest tool, or a blessed. We are blessed with the greatest tool, and our forefathers worked on a greatest science. And this science is not so easiest science to understand. And it is far beyond the concept which has been which that we can understand actually. நம்மளால் புரிஞ்சிக்கொள்ளவே முடியாத அளவுக்கு ஒரு கான்செப்டை டிரைவ் பண்ணி அதை ப்ராக்டிஸ் மெத்தடில் கொடுத்து ரிசர்ச் பண்ணுறது. இப்போ இருக்கிற ரிசர்ச் டெக்னாலஜியை விட ஃபார் பெட்டர் அட்வான்ஸாக ரிசர்ச் பண்ணி பாடி ப்ரிப்பரேஷன், மென்டல் ப்ரிப்பரேஷன், பிராணா, சூத்ராஸ், கிளன்சிங், அப்புறம் பந்தாஸ், முத்ராஸ், மந்த்ராஸ், எவ்வளோ ஃபார்மெட்ஸு, ஸ்டார்டிங் ஃப்ரம் ஃபிசிக்கல் டு சோஷியல் டு ஸ்பிரிச்சுவல், a concept which people cannot even think about even in the advanced space. They thought it very, very early, and then they made it very clear the methods, where it you have to start, how you can start, how you can modify. That is unlimited, and it is about not practicing something in the morning and evening 1 hour munnadi pandradilla. It is about the way of living. So we should be proud as to celebrate it, or to be just being a human, we should be able to understand the science of yoga, the science of this world living technique, which gives you a clear vision towards to achieve the greatest goal. Let's all be happy for that, and happy morning to everybody, those who are just being live. Do some poses, do some understanding, do some pranayamam every day, so that we will be doing this yoga, and then we will call this as a practitioner of every day. Let's try to do it for 15 to 20 minutes every day in the morning, so that it becomes a habit, so that thereby you don't have to do celebrate on this special day. We are going to celebrate and do it, and if you're not going to do, then you will definitely miss the benefit of the yoga. Okay, love you all so much. Thank you. This is Vijay, a fitness consultant. And today being an International Yoga Day, I thought we will have a few poses, and for understanding we will do some asanas which will work on the body to flex it, to challenge you. And because asanas has four different, in yoga there are different paces. It's like, for example, Janana Yogam, that you born and you go to the next pace is Janana Yogam. There is something that we call it as Karma Yogi, as somebody who wanted to do something for most of you are watching. Most of us are all Karma Yogis, where we try to do something, thereby we get it happiness, and we find we are happy and contented. We are happy in the sense of doing anything and thereby achieving something. We are all Karma Yogis actually, but Karma Yogi does not expect something which will come from doing, and it's definitely a far behind concept. And Bhakti Yogam is just praying to God and becoming surrendering to God. Like, there are unlimited types of yogas that we have. Doing asanas and pranayamam is just part of it. It's just a preparation of your body, and thereby with the prana we can connect it the mind. That's very simple. So today let's start some movements on the body. So thereby, because we are all in a very, very external understanding of yoga still, and I see some of my friends are practicing different poses to achieve different poses, bending and flexing, all these things. And if the mind is not being flexible in the process, you miss the process. Okay, and I hope my audio is clear. If one of my friends or BCD people, if you are watching, can you just give me a thumbs up by just saying your audio is clear, so that I can just go ahead with the process. And to start with, and I'm going to give you five different poses that you can do just when you get up from the bed, that you can do, thereby you can just start up your day. So you don't have to specially prepare for it, because every part of our body movement, every part of our work that is being doing, it is an asana actually. Can I have Gopi brother, happy International Yoga Day, and for the BCD friends, happy International Yoga Day. Joseph brother, vanakkam, and being there, happy, thank you so much, and seeing you all live after a long time. Excellent, sir, thank you. Right, let's start this session with a simple movement exercises, and in a lying down, because and I told you that we will be doing some, I'll be showing you some asanas or movements that you will be able to do when you get up from the bed. So just for example, நீங்கள் எழுந்திருக்கீங்க பெட்டில் அப்போவே உடனே பண்ணுற மாதிரி. ஓகே, ஸோ தட் யூ டோன்ட் ஹேவ் டு ஸ்பெஷலி ப்ரிப்பேர் ஃபார் இட் அண்ட் தென் யூ கேன் யா. ஸோ யூ ஆர் லைங் டவுன், லெட்ஸ் அஸ்யூம் தட் யூ ஆர் லைங் டவுன், பெண்ட் யுவர் லெக்ஸ், புட் யுவர் லெக்ஸ் சைட் டு சைட், ஜஸ்ட் இன்ஹேல், எக்ஸ்ஹேல், எக்ஸ்ஹேல், லெக்ஸ் கேன் பி லிட்டில் வைடர். Just do this 5 repetitions or 5 times on right and left. So we are stretching the ankle, we are doing the movement of the knee and the hip and your spine. Okay, the second one, bring your legs and then stretch, extend. Bring your legs, breathe out, stretch, extend. Just bring your one leg, extend. Just do this for 5 times. Breathe out, breathe in. Breathe out, breathe in. Breathe out, breathe in. Breathe out, breathe in. Okay, now, your hands up. To the side, gently turn to one side, touch the arm, and then come up to the other side, so that you get up in the bed. You can do this so that you just or you can lie down, you can prepare yourself and do this, so you are stretching your spine, and you're trying to twist your shoulders, that we are getting warmed up. Just do this for 5 times. Your arm to the side, arm to the side. I'm just turning myself further so that you can do it easily. Your arm up, stretch and then relax. Inhale, exhale. Inhale your arm up, exhale down. Inhale your arm up, exhale, inhale, exhale. Now gently turn to the side, face down, face down, face down. Slowly raise it up, down. Bend your legs, down. Up, inhale, exhale. Up, inhale, exhale. You're doing up and down with your body and your legs, so it is easy, so that your body gets warmed up. So we are trying to do all the basic movements of the body. We are activating all the joints. Relax. You look up, look down. Look in the front, look down. For the neck up and down, and to turn to right and left in a lying down pose. So it is becoming a functional movement. Okay. Right, the next one. Next last movement that we can do, you are in a kneel down position, squat back, that is your butt on the heel, and then come back to normal. Squat back, come back. So this one movement will stretch your ankle. You stretch your ankle, you stretch your ankle, and you stretch your knee and hip joint. And you go back to your shoulder, and you look in the front for this neck. And when you put your hip down in the camel pose, it stretches the most of the joints in one simple pose. Thereby you activate your most of the joints. Asanas or the movements that I am showing, you have different names. If you are not able to familiar with the names, it's fine. But doing the movements is important. Okay, I hope you are ready with the basic warm up that we did. Yeah, we need a warm up. Because doing performing asanas, or when you perform asanas, you may have to challenge your joints muscles so that your muscles can get more strength. Thereby you can demand oxygen, thereby you can concentrate on your prana, thereby the connection between your body and mind can happen better. The whole aim of asana practice is to prepare your body. Thereby you connect your breath, and thereby you connect the mind. Body, mind, connection. Yes, that's what in yoga we say. And it is just a very simple understanding, connecting the body and mind. It will take maybe a lifetime. Sometime we may not be able to understand that, we will have to go for the next jananam also. That's very easy. And ஒரு சில நேரங்களில் நம்ம உடற்பயிற்சியை நிறைய செய்து செய்து உடற்பயிற்சியும் பிராணத்தையும் ஒன்றாக கலப்பதற்கு முயற்சி செய்வோம். ஒருவேளை முயற்சி செய்து நம்மளால் அதை பண்ண முடியல அப்படின்னும் போது, தென் வி ஆட்டோமேட்டிக்லி வி ஷிஃப்ட் இன் டு த நெக்ஸ்ட் ஜனனம், அண்ட் விச் இவென்ச்சுவலி ஹேப்பன்ஸ் ஃபார் மோஸ்ட் ஆஃப் அஸ் ஆக்சுவலி. அண்ட் தட்ஸ் வை வி கோ ஃபார் ரீபர்த் வென் வி டோன்ட் அண்டர்ஸ்டாண்ட் த பர்பஸ் ஆஃப் த லைஃப் ஆர் த ப்ராசஸ் ஆஃப் த லைஃப். பர்பஸ் அண்ட் ப்ராசஸ் இஸ் டிஃப்ரெண்ட், பிகாஸ் ப்ராசஸ் ஹேப்பன்ஸ் ஃபார் த பர்பஸ் டு அண்டர்ஸ்டாண்ட். ஸோ இட்ஸ் கிரேட்டஸ்ட் லெவல்ஸ் ஆஃப் அண்டர்ஸ்டாண்டிங். For example, few qualities of being selfishness, being pure, clean, or the basic first level, yama, niyamam, are the two different basic fundamental process of yoga to start with. Then it goes to asanam, then it goes to pranayamam, pratyaharam, dhyana, dharna, samadhi. These are the eightfold path that we have. Okay, with that, I will give you five different poses today, five different poses. These five poses are very important that everybody can practice, so that it is easy for people, so that you can just do this. Thereby we can activate all the joint. One will be a flexibility, two it will be a immunity increasing asanas, the third is to give you strength, because there are three different purpose that we generally do. We flex our body, we become more stronger, and we want to become stronger with the joints and muscles. The third is thereby we can increase the immunity, and thereby your basic survival becomes better and easy, so that asanas can work. Right? Right. Let's start the process. Please have water if you are doing with me. Okay. The first asana is the Paschimottha Asanam, which is with a series of having your legs in the front. Thereby we are going to trying to connect the legs, and the preparation is just you are seated in a long seated position, hands to the side. So relax your legs to the side to side, your spine is straight, and you are trying to go forward, and you are going to take your arm and go forward and trying to reach, okay, and you are trying to reach your ankle or your forehead to the knee. Okay, do to the pace or do to the form where you are comfortable. Okay, spine straight, arm up, inhale, just inhale, exhale, and then take your arm up and then down, legs to the side. And we will be reaching it slowly. Take your arm up, inhale. Reach forward more. Inhale, exhale. 4, 3, 2, 1. Slowly up. every asana will have a break, and the amount of seconds that you held there can be the break for you. The last time, take your arm up. Now slightly try to touch the toes, trying to touch the toes or pull the toes. Take your arm down. Look to the front. Okay. And as I told you, five different poses. This is the first seated pose. In the seated pose, we have a variation now. We have variation. One leg bend. You'll do forward bending, two or three poses, and you'll do backward bending, two or three poses. And in a standing, two or three poses, which is forward, backward, and sideward. So that we complete all the movements of the body, thereby you are completing your body requirements like forward, backward, sideward, or twisting, something like that, right? That's the basic concept of understanding in the beginning of yoga doing, right? Okay, one leg bend, other straight, your spine straight, take your arm up, bend down, reach forward. You can touch the toes or you can reach wherever you're comfortable. And then take your arm up and then relax. The other side. Take your arm up. Inhale. Bend down. Inhale, exhale. And slowly up. We'll do repeat the other leg. We'll do at least a minimum of two times so that we get used to the push pose as well as we send prana. The aim of the every pose is one, to be very comfortable in the pose. Two is to send the prana to the pose, to the particular muscle or the joint. Thereby we get regenerated, right? Okay. Thank you, Ramak. Welcome. Happy morning. So international, happy in International Yoga Day to people. We are just trying to do some basic poses. Thereby we are celebrating by doing, just not wishing each other by an International Yoga Day. So that you can do some poses, thereby you can celebrate it better than just wishing orally. Yeah, you can join me and then you can do some pose, basic poses. If you are able to roll with one leg, it's fine. Or if you are able to open the opposite side, it's fine. Or you are able to reach it this way, but still you feel your body is feeling the stretch or feeling the pressure on the joints, it's perfect. And you should be able to enjoy the pressure. And then come back. You should not feel like, wow, it is not, I am not able to do, and don't hold the breath in the pose. Yeah. Come up. Okay, so we did one straight leg, the two bent leg, the third one is butterfly in a seated pose. So these are the three basic poses in a seated pose. Anybody should be able to do it. Practice it so that the maintaining the flexibility of the back, hamstring, calf, and hip region. So that these are the basic three poses on a seated one. So I told you five. The first one is like seated one, leg straight, one leg, and then the bend leg now, which is the butterfly pose, Bhakta Konasanam. Okay, but do not worry about the poses, because worrying about the names of the poses is not going to bring you anything. If you are able to do it perfectly with your body, and if you are able to experience it, it's perfect. The legs bend. To activate, you can just do up and down, few dynamic flips up and down. மூன்று ஆசனங்கள் சொல்லியிருக்கேன். ஒன்று கால்களை நீட்டி பச்சிமோத்தாசனம், தலையை தொடர மாதிரி, தலை வந்து கீழே போடுற மாதிரி, கையை தொடர மாதிரி. இன்னொன்று காலை நீட்டி ஜானு சிரசாசனம் சொல்லுவோம், ஒரு காலை மடக்கி கால் நீட்டுறது. மூன்றாவது உங்களுடைய பட்டர்ஃப்ளை வடிவம் பக்த கோணாசனம் சொல்கிறாங்க. செருப்பு தைக்கிறவங்க உட்காந்துருப்பாங்க அப்படின்னு சொல்லுவாங்கள்ல. ஆமாம், ஸோ இந்த போஸ், இட்ஸ் த ஒன் சிம்பிள் போஸ், எனிபடி கேன் டூ, விமன், மென் அண்ட் வயசானவங்க, குழந்தைங்க, யாராலையும் எல்லாராலையும் பண்ண முடியும். ஒன் சிம்பிள் ஆசனா டு ஆக்டிவேட் யுவர் ஹோல் எனர்ஜி சிஸ்டம், அண்ட் வேர் இட் கிவ்ஸ் யூ ப்ரெஷர் ஃப்ரம் த லோயர் அப்டமன் அண்ட் இட் ஆக்டிவேட்ஸ் த மூலாதாரம். ரொம்ப ரொம்ப இம்பார்ட்டன்ட் போஸ். ஓகே, யா, ஒன்ஸ் யூ ஆர் ஏபிள் டு டூ திஸ், யூ கேன், இஃப் யூ ஆர் ஏபிள் டு டூ, இஃப் யூர் இயர் இட்ஸ் ஃபைன், டோன்ட் வரி அபவுட் இட். இஃப் யூர் இயர் இட்ஸ், டோன்ட் வரி அபவுட் இட். சி, யுவர் பாடி, you can find which part is tight. Actually, right left வித்தியாசமாக இருக்கும். ஒரு சில பேர் இது கீழே இருக்கும், இது மேலே தூக்கியிருக்கும். எவ்வளோ தூரம் கம்ஃபர்டபுளாக இருக்கோ அங்கேயே இருங்க. ரைட், வித் த ஸ்பைன் ஸ்ட்ரைட், ஸ்லோலி பெண்ட் டவுன், ரீச் டவுன், See, if you are able to reach here, it's fine. Or if you are able to bend down, it's fine. Just be there where you are comfortable. Inhale, exhale. And then slowly up. If you wanted to do a little better, you can have your legs in the front. So that it will be easy for you. If bringing your closer will be able to, you will not be able to flex more, or you will not be able to press it down, right? So have your legs slightly in the front, you will be able to do it better. Inhale, exhale. Okay, so relax, cross leg sitting. Okay, so if you understand the way of living of for a yogi, because people are having different questions asking me about why we should be doing this every day. In olden days, they have not practiced that way, because yoga is meant for people, those who lived on those days, those who follow the basic principles of doing their work for whatever the work for themselves they have to do by them, but they have to do right, and they don't ask others to do even washing. Like, you need to take bath, you need to go to a river or for a place where is the tank is there, or maybe you get to go into the sea or you come back. So you walk around, you search for and for food, or you, that's the way they lived actually. Or they did that. They don't have AC on those days. There is no sophistications like car, two wheeler, like things like that are not there. So it is different on those days. So to do yogam or to practice yogam on those days is different. Nowadays it is different for an understanding. You have to do it every day, and you need to practice all different poses or different poses accordingly planned, so that you're challenging your body. That's the important for understanding. You challenge your body, thereby you increase your prana and concentrate on the prana, and thereby you achieve the mind. It is totally a different understanding. But just doing 1 hour Surya Namaskar, let's say for example, people do for 25 Surya Namaskar, 40, 100, 108, different exercises, different people will go for it, right? It's not about that, okay? Right, let's go to the reverse pose of asana. The first one is then kneeling down, okay, hands on the hip, push your hip back forward, hip in the front, look up, just inhale, exhale, 4, 3, 2, 1, relax. Gently go down, happy morning to everybody. Since I'm doing it from there, I'm not able to. If you have been asking anything or saying anything, I will not be able to reply to it. Just a minute, so that I can just do that also. So we have just started with the basic few sitting poses. Okay. Thank you. Happy morning to everybody. Okay, Selva sir. Suresh sir, happy morning. Shankaran sir, happy morning. Santosh sir, Selva, Narayan sir, Manigandan brother, Bona ma'am, Vanakkam. Narayan sir, happy morning. Chitra ma'am, Gopi brother, happy morning. Yeah, Ruben brother, Subhashni ma'am, Vanakkam, happy morning. Very nice, thank you. Right, so great. Hi to everybody. Happy and thank you. Okay, let's do, because it's about just doing. And if you have any queries, you can just post it there. If you are going to wish, or if you are doing, if you are practicing, I'll be very happy. And any practice which will make your body demand physical effort, thereby you challenge your physique, thereby your mental abilities are improving, thereby you are getting matured for the process of living, that can be called as yogam, according to me. Do not worry about it. Every exercise that we do, bend forward, turning, twisting, that we do it in the gym or gymnasium, is all meant with the names of yoga or asanas. We just do not know the names. That's very simple. Okay? Right. Let's go to the second time of backward bending. Hands on the hip. Push your hip forward. Inhale, exhale. So it's important to do backward bend, than the forward bend, because we are, our posture is always in the front, so it is important to go forward. If you're not able to sit like this, you can just have put a pillow, or you can just have your hands here, or you can just like this also is fine. Nothing wrong. Okay, and one variation on the backward bend, legs slightly wider. Okay, the Ustrasanam form that we are doing, a camel form. Take your arm back, trying to hold it. Take your arm back, trying to hold it. Push your head. 4, 3, 2. Just go to the form and come back, so that you are practicing asana. We are just not like going up, going in the form and just coming up like this will not be a proper form. So go slowly and come back to the form very slowly, so that you are exactly practicing what is supposed to be a yoga form should be, right? Okay, that's the first backward bend that we are doing. Okay, and for the reverse, we are going to do two more on the lying down, so that. So it get compensated with the three asanas that we did. It is important to do forward or backward, so right and left accordingly, so that we are exactly fulfilling the rule of how to do an asana. Asanas has basic rules. Few rules are: one, if you do forward, backward, or side to left accordingly, we should be able to do. We should not force the pose, because if you are going to pose, if you are going to, let's say for example, you are not able to go down more. You are trying to go with strenuous feeling, and it is not asana, which we don't call it as asana. The third one is, you need to concentrate on the breath, and you need to do every day or regularly, so that you are exactly fulfilling what is asana is, or what is about the content of yoga, or the basic sutra of yoga has been understood, right? Okay. In a kneeling down position, starting position. Hip down, so you are in the reverse pose. Forward bend we have done on a sitting poses, and then on to the kneeling pose. Relax yourself in this pose. Nithyanand, happy morning. Thank you so much. Shankar sir, vanakkam. Nice. Thank you, ma'am. One more time. Trying to be hip down and the shoulder lifted up, not like this, up, looking straight. Inhale, exhale. Inhale, exhale. And then up. The last pose for the reverse pose that we are doing. Leg back, hip down. Nithyanand vanakkam, Rukmarudra vanakkam. Nice, thank you so much. Yeah, now we did forward and we are going to do the backward, which is holding the legs. Dhanurasanam, legs hold it. You can do single leg holding and then lift it up. Your hand to the side. Relax the other side, and we are going to do the double leg also. If you are okay with double leg, you can do, but doing single leg is also another very important form. So you can push your spine and then you can go up. Your hands to the forehead, relax yourself. One more time. Hold your legs back, pull it up. It's a double leg, slowly down. Relax for some few times, 3 seconds. And then slowly come up. So we did six different poses now. Seated one, double leg front and bend forward. Kaal neeti munadi thodrudhu. Single leg bend forward. Pachimottasanam. ஜானு சிரசாசனம் தேர்ட் ஒன் இஸ் த பட்டர்ஃப்ளை போஸ் அது வந்து நம்ம பக்த கோணாசனம் சொல்கிறோம் வி கால் இட் இஸ் பக்த கோணாசனம் ஆர் த காப்லர்ஸ் போஸ் அண்ட் ஃபார் த ரிவர்ஸ் வி டிட் த நீல் டவுன் போஸ் வித் உஷ்ட்ராசனம் வித் ஒன் ஹிப் இன் ஹேண்ட்ஸ் ஆன் த ஹிப் ஃபார் யுவர் பேக் சப்போர்ட் டூ இஸ் யுவர் ஆர்ம் எக்ஸ்டெண்டிங் பேக் அண்ட் அந்த வேரியேஷன் ஆஃப் தட் அண்ட் தென் த புஜங்காசனம் இஸ் ஜஸ்ட் நார்மலி ஸ்ட்ரெச்சிங் யுவர் பேக் அண்ட் தனுராசனம் ஸோ நவ் வி டிட் ஃபார்வர்ட் பேக்வர்ட் சைட்வர்ட் பின் ஆன் சீட்டட் ஃபார்ம் and we'll go to the standing form we'll do forward backward and sideward and we'll do one twist thereby we were done for the day we just have to see this has to be practiced every day if you practice these basic four or five these asanas that I see one is the sitting another one is the reverse that sitting forward backward I told you standing so that the five different combinations that we have to do that I'm going to put it very clearly so that it makes very simple so that you can practice this alternate days one day you can do walking one day you can go for a run cycling one day you can do this thereby you can regain your flexibility and strength of your different joints and the muscles thereby it gives you better benefit actually right so let's go to the standing pose forward back forward bend and we'll just so sister vanakkam happy morning long time okay one is the first one is a forward bend padasthasanam arm up legs wider bend down gently try to reach down if you're comfortable be there if you can touch the toes is fine or rest yourself is done but be there where you're comfortable knee straight after three inhalation or five inhalation exhalation slowly come up We'll do, since it's in a standing form, it will be easy for us to do the reverse form. Hands on the hip, push your hip back, and then bend back. So, Pirayasanam, and forward we do, standing, Pada Hastasanam. So, Padam refers to the foot. Bend, Munadi bend pandra the Pada Hastasanam solrom. Backward bend pandra the. Pirayasanam solrom half moon pose mari backward bending bend as much as possible so that you feel the pressure on the back and you stretch the anterior segment nare nerangla na and mari asanam pannumbodhu enga feel padringa kekku enga stretch nu sonina idu pannumbodhu inga stretch nu solvanga idu contract avudhu idu stretch avudhu adhu romba simplest understanding adhu nammukku andha feeling vanduchinave podu actually right okay one more time we'll do legs wider arm up inhale Exhale, bend down. Knee straight. Inhale, exhale. Or if you are here, it's fine. Do not push yourself too much. And take your hip back, hands on the hip. Push your hip forward. So just one forward backward it's perfect so that we are just doing the movement which is required for the body to function comfortably regularly or we call this not being underused the poses because we have been overusing this pose and if you do this backward bend we are done actually we are perfectly done if you are a corporate person if you are a sitting person or a person who is going to work on the desktop Just doing a reverse bend is more than enough for you to activate the reverse group of muscles. There will be organs on the internal abdomen segment will be activated better and then you will be able to meet the demands of the physiological demands, right? Okay. Now the sideward. Legs wider. Keep your arm up. So one arm down to the right side. Turn the right foot. Gently bend to the side. You can go down as much as possible if you can or you just stay in this pose if you have you bend it and do also is fine or you can have it straight so knees bend knees straight and I'm just bending it inhale exhale if you can touch it's fine the touching the toes or touching the ground and slowly come we'll do the next time when we do we'll do the arm resting down so that it be some of you wanted to do that So we are doing the side bend. Inhale, exhale. Just they call it as Trigonasanam sometimes, they call it as Arthagaddi Chakrasanam, sideward bend. There are different names that they give, but just bending to the side, really forward, backward, sideward, sideward. Now it's going to be a twist, now it's going to be a twist. Right? Stand straight, cock your hands, cross your legs, take your hands in the front. You can cross your hands like this. You can turn to right side and then to the other side. This can be gently done with the legs crossed and bending to the side. So you twisted your spine, the legs, and you are switching the spine and you can turn. For easy, so that you can have it like this. For some of you wanting to do this, twist and then turn. Right, chain the leg, cross leg, firm your legs, twist. You need to go to both the sides to feel the twist. And then relax. The easiest form of the twist people wanting to do is legs wider, hand to the side, turn gently to the right side. You can have your neck here, or you can turn back more for your wherever the position is comfortable. Hand to the side. Slowly to the other side. Be there. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. So I did the twist, side bending, forward, backward. So these are the simple poses that which will cover all the body movements. And you don't have to be like doing jump, turn, twist, Ukkatasana. There are so many things. The asanas are unlimited actually. And we're just doing the basic form so that it will be easy for people to follow. And you can practice these poses number of times that according to your requirement. Basically, it is just 2 times. Maximum you can do 6 times. Holding it for somewhere around 3 breaths to 10 breaths actually. It's more than enough for you to attain the flexibility. And one asanam to increase the ability of the brain for the children is just Vrikshasanam. Vrikshasanam is standing in single leg actually. We'll do the single leg and we'll go into the meditation, like breathe prana, extra few pranas, and then we'll finish the session. Vrikshasanam is just single leg stance. One leg you can put it on the ankle or on the knee or on the hip. The spine straight. Take your arm, stretch your arm up. Focus the position. If you can, close your eyes and then be there. 3, 2, 1. If you lose balance, open your eyes and you can close your eyes again for 3 seconds. And then focus the position. Relax. You take your arm down. Relax. Let's go to the next leg, the other leg. Hold it. Be comfortable in holding it. Put it down on the knee or to the wrist. It is perfectly fine. And putting it to the groin region is the exact pose. Stretch the arm up. Looking straight. Once you get the position, focus. Close your eyes. Just be there for 3 seconds. And then relax. Open your eyes. Again, focus the position. Close your eyes. You can increase the seconds slowly. Open it. Arm down. Legs away. Hands out to the side. Inhale, exhale. Just practicing this single leg stance will activate your brain. And the children's, the kids that they want to get their attention and get best knowledge, they want to read better or they want to get more intellectually defined, like they can practice this simple pose every day, thereby they get the best effort of it, right? Okay, thank you. And we'll do some basic prana. Pranayam, we can just sit on Padmasanam or the single Suhasanam, or cross leg sitting if you can. If you can do a cross leg sitting, this would be great. And trying to practice this also is very nice actually. cross leg sitting, your spine straight. I'll do only one prana, concentrating on the breath, which is a simple Kumbhaka pranayamam, where you inhale, hold, exhale. Three processes there in prana. Inhale, you can have chin mudra or you can have palm facing up. Inhale, hold it, exhale. Inhale, hold, exhale. Wherein we have three pace of breathing. There are different formats, and all these prana should have been practiced very with according to the prescription, because pranayama it will alter your pressure. Some of you are having health issues, should definitely contact your physiotherapist or yoga therapist or a trainer who have known about asanas and yoga, because pranayama, if you do wrong, it can elevate your blood sugar levels, it can elevate your BP, it can drop your sugar levels. It is very simple, because if you hold the prana, then it will be a trouble for you, because pranayama is not so easiest thing like doing in a pose, because doing a pose become more of physical, but prana, which will connect your physiological system, thereby connects your mind. So I've seen people doing Kapalabhati 100 times in utter stretch, and I don't know how it is possible. When you do a one breath, you can do few exhalations, which is being possible and easy. Science has to be interpreted, understood carefully, and you have to practice to your requirements, not just people asking you to do, that way you can do. And so that's why I'm choosing one simple Kumbhaka pranayamam, where you have an inhalation, holding, exhalation. Do all the processes at your pace and easy. Exhalation can be longer, so that inhalation will be more nourished and you get breath, right? Just a minute, excuse me for a minute. All right. Thank you so much. Yeah, just do the inhalation, exhalation, so that the simple Kumbhaka pranayama is just doing this prana, thereby you do inhalation, holding, and exhalation. That is very, it's more than enough for somebody who wanted to do keep the heart rate low. Exhalation longer will reduce the diaphragmatic pressure, thereby your heart rate comes down. Holding the breath longer, yes, it's good, but if you are not doing it properly, if you are holding it too long, then it is a trouble, and I would not suggest people to do by themselves, right? Doing asana practice or exercise is just taking a few advice from people, learning some Surya Namaskar, and doing it properly is good. Doing 108 or 24, 50 and all, just doing 8 repetition properly is more than enough, I would say. If you are not practicing forward, backward, sideward, as like I told you, turning, twisting, if you are not compensating all these forces, then you are in trouble. So please, on this yoga day, let's understand if the requirement of the body, understand, let's not push the poses, let's not push it harder, thereby you strain yourself rather by training yourself. Physical training is different, achieving the mental training is different. Yoga has different levels, as I told you. Let's train it according to the requirement, safely. Because safety is first, whatever the process that we do, that I, according to me, according to the Smart Sun Wellness, what we are practicing, what I am been practicing this last 13-14 years, is very simple. Safety first and your comfort, thereby you achieve it slowly by time. And let's not fix the time, because if your body is refusing, you need to give time, thereby you will be able to adopt it. I hope this is very clear, and you can just practice this every day, and if you have any queries, you can just drop me, thereby we will do more number of sessions if it is required, and you can just celebrate the day by doing it. Thank you so much. Narayan sir, 108 Surya Namaskar, excellent. Wow, that's great. So they have been practicing regularly. If you have been practicing regularly, it is perfect. Doing it slowly, correct the posture, concentrate the prana, and you are achieved. So thank you, love you all so much for participating in this session that I wanted to have. Let's celebrate by doing, by celebrate by living. by let's celebrate every day. We have been celebrating every different days comes. We do it on that particular day, that way we post something and we leave it, and it is not actually meant it for that. You have to do it regularly, and especially on this yoga day, being a great art of this world, I would suggest people to take it seriously. Teach your kids, teach your children, because this should not go down, because this has to be taken to the next level of understanding. Thank you. Love you all so much. Great day to you all. Please drink water and you can relax yourself. Have an excellent day.